Minnesota.
Mm-hmm. Keep needing to move. Thank you. Palin was going faster. That's the third coal train I saw since I came here. That freight train stopped down there. How is it gonna get through? Well, it's not on main track 2. It's on main track 1 where the other one is.
Yeah.
was going fast on track two. Oh, empty battery. Last train for today. I gotta head back to the depot. UP train and HO. UP train and HO. HO scale.
Is that what they have at the Model Railroad Club?
Yeah, HO scale, yeah.
The big industry here back around the turn of the century. Little town of Fraser down here. Well, it doesn't amount to a whole lot anymore. Back in the coal mining days, it was a rip-roaring money town. They needed a way to get the coal out.
So
the line began to build a line about 4 miles away to a junction with another railroad. Well, back
Chicago
in those days, railroads were expanding. They built on up north of Fort Dodge, Rockwell City, on in here to Boone, and then down to Little Timoy. Well, the line had several different names at first, but about 1907, there was a known as the Fort Dodge Des Moines and Southern. And they ran trolley cars back and forth between Des Moines and Fort Dodge. In the heyday of the operation, they had a car every hour. But when the automobiles came along, of course, this cut into business, so the frequency of operation was greatly cut back. But service did remain on the line until 1955. At that time, they removed the electrification, and it became a diesel freight line for a number of years. By this time, one of the principal customers was the gypsum mills up in Fort Dodge. In 1968, the Chicago Northwestern took over this line. They had other lines in the Fort Dodge area. So going into the 1970s, this line was dealt with for the last 9 states. Going to the back of the bus down the road, a lot of people here kicked around the idea of a city track out here along the Des Moines River Valley. Nobody really thought it was that kind of money around. Fortunately, there were some people who believed in the idea. But in 1983, when the line came up for abandonment, a group got started here. They started talks with the Northwestern, and in June of 1983, we signed an agreement to buy 11 miles of track for $50,000. A little bit later that same summer, we heard about a diesel locomotive. It was government surplus on an Air Force base in Texas. We could have it for $1,000. But getting it shipped up here was another story because we had to load it on a top car and unload it here. But we got it here in the fall of 83. We ran our first trip then in November that year. Today we're going to Fraser, which is 7.5 miles. Now we got another 4 more miles of track. And on the weekend, we have our dinner train, the yellow train that we just passed back there at the depot. It goes out every Friday and Saturday night. And then on Saturday noon, it goes out as a dessert train. On Sunday noon, it goes out as a picnic train. You bring along your own picnic. Then also on Friday, we have our, or Saturday rather, we have our steam locomotive. This is the last locomotive manufactured on the face of the earth. It was built at Deep Home China, December 1988. We paid just under $400,000 for the locomotive. We got $150,000 through the Iowa Lottery Commission. The remainder was financed by the agency. If you have questions, what I'm here for, hope you enjoy your trip. Used them on gravel roads. But that one has been left intact. That was the last coal mine closed here in the mid-1940s. We call it Mount Boone.
Over there.
Cornfield. Field corn.
It's a bunch of ties.
Is the Kate Shelley High Bridge. That's the highest double track bridge in the world. That bridge is 188
Stop
feet high.
Up. Stop standing
and
up.
About a half mile long. And that carries traffic for what is today Union Pacific, formerly Chicago Northwestern. They run around 60 trains a day over that bridge. Now the original Kate Shelley Bridge was built about 1901, and it consists it lasted for over 100 years.
Could you sit but down now,
about
please?
2009, the Union Pacific decided to replace it with a brand new concrete structure right next to the old one.
That was 800 feet.
And it's about 3 feet higher than the old one and has a speed limit of around 50 miles an hour.
That was weird. 50 miles an hour. Wow. I guess it was.
Can we go back and go backwards? Look at that rod up there.
That's the second one, sorry. We're going to be arriving in Fraser now in just a moment. There's not a whole lot here anymore, but back in the town's heyday, 1893 to 1912, they officially had a population of around 2,000. But apparently there was a large migratory workforce that worked here. There are estimates the population may have been as high as 5,000. Today, there's only 130 people that still call Fraser home, and they all live on the other side of the river.
comes the railroad crossing. Railroad crossing lights. Fraser's Spring.
Come to a stop here in just a moment.
Oh, here comes Bob
the
plane.
Locomotive is going to one hook, and then it's going to go around the train on a sidetrack, hook onto the other end. Now, why they're going to do that, we're going to ask that everybody on the left moves to the right, and everybody on the right moves to the left. And then we're going to flip over the seats, so you'll be facing the opposite direction. Now please wait until we get stopped. This isn't it. And we give you the okay to move.
Well, they're moving. Aunt Susan, you want to come sit here?
He wants you to come back.
Crazy grandma. Whole bunch of nature right out this window.
Yep.
You got to ride it.
No, not the trestle, but the river. Raccoon River.
Pretty good view. This is where you can take the canoes and kayaks and go because it's shallow.
Oh.
There's no sandbars.
It's a lot smoother on the bridge.
Low as it is.
Yeah, I am too.
Hey, Grandma. The trestle's way smoother than the actual railroad.
Yeah.
They've got lots of stuff.
Yeah. And that's a creek. Creepy creek.
I
to the beach. Yeah. Here comes the railroad car. Gonna be another one coming here in 5 minutes or so. Thank you. It started up really fast and now it stopped. Really. Where's the, oh, there's the end. DPUs. I wonder what happened. Brakes are applied.